Well, we know her and love her as Lady Cora Crowley on Downton Abbey. Now she is back in the jazz age with her new film, The Chaperone. Welcome, Elizabeth McGovern. So good to see you. I'm such a huge fan.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for coming this morning. First of all, we've got to ask you about Downton Abbey. We're hearing about the movie. It's already been shot. Can you tell us anything about when it's going to be out? Any details at all?
I know it's coming out in September, okay. And I know we did it.
Yeah. Right. Okay.
That's good. That I can tell you.
Well, you know what? Is it just like Downton Abbey, but in movie form? Or
yeah.
Is it going to be different because it's in movie form?
No.
It's the same.
It's the same.
But better.
But better. But I think you'll see all your favorite characters saying what they say.
Uh-huh. Right.
You know.
Right.
And so it's for the fans. It's for people that want to go back there.
Well, I do. I want
to
go back there right now.
Good.
How was it going back there to like Highclere Castle, seeing everybody again? I mean, a lot of time passed. How was it getting back together?
It was kind of just like we never left.
Really?
Yeah, it was weird.
Yeah, that's great.
It was fun.
So this is really cool. I listened to a lot of audiobooks, uh-huh. And she was actually recording the audiobook for The Chaperone. Mm-hmm. And what happened?
Well, a light bulb went off in my head. It doesn't happen very often. And I thought, this needs to be a movie. It's just a great story. So I kind of fixated on this idea. And now, 8 years later, it is a film coming out, hopefully near you.
And you bought the rights.
I bought the rights. I took them to Julian, who I thought was a pretty good screenwriter.
You guys worked together on Downton Abbey,
yeah,
right?
Yeah. Julian Fellows.
Right.
And we've made this movie that I feel so proud of. It's really delightful. It's fresh. And it's about two women who meet each other. They're different, but they help each other. And they learn from each other. And it's the older one that finds love.
Oh, yeah. I didn't
know
that
So I thought that
part.
Was kind of unusual.
Yeah.
You
yeah.
don't see that. It's
right.
like, that doesn't happen to older women. But, you know, it can. We don't die.
No.
We're still alive. It's a cool story.
You can see the excitement in your eyes and hear it, how delighted you are that it's actually happened.
I'm not only delighted, I'm completely shocked.
Right. Really?
Yeah, even still to this day. But I'm loving it. I'm just having the greatest time going around the country with it. It's been really fun.
Well, before we show a clip, will you just tell people real quick? It's about Louise Brooks, who was like an icon in the 20s and 30s, and you are her chaperone. Can you tell
us a
little bit about Louise?
Yes. In real life, Louise Brooks, who grew up in Wichita, Kansas, travels to New York on a train. And she begins life as a dancer. She's studying there.
Right.
She is accompanied by a middle-aged housewife. We know that. That
is
did
fact.
Happen.
Right.
That's fact. Laura Moriarty took this kernel of truth, and she said to herself, I'm very interested in this story, and I'm interested in that unknown middle-aged housewife. Who was she? What's her story? Why was she in New York? Why did she accompany this young girl? How did they know each other? What happened that summer? We know what happened to Louise Brooks. She impacted America in a huge way.
She did.
She became an icon. She symbolized sexual liberation. It's what happened to the housewife who went through this experience with her.
Let's look at a clip of The Chaperone. Nice setup, by the way.
Yeah.
Get people to give you ice cream for nothing.
But it's not for nothing, is it? I get the ice cream and they get the pleasure of my company.
Well, I'm not sure I should encourage you.
You mean I'm getting fat?
No.
You're right. They'll only pick a few of us to join the company and they won't choose me if I'm fat.
Does your mother know you want to join the company? Because she never mentioned it to me. I thought it was just a chorus to learn dance.
Myra said you wouldn't like it to be escorting a professional coochie-coochie girl. You should have more faith in yourself, Norm. There are plenty of men out there who'd be delighted to give you some free ice cream. You just have to ask.
Don't be ridiculous.
Oh, this looks good.
It looks great.
Does.
It really looks good. Thank you so much for coming. I love seeing you in everything, but especially these period dramas. Thank you again.
Oh, thank you so much for having me.
Such a huge fan. The Chaperone opens this Friday at Laemmle Royal, Laemmle Playhouse 7, and Laemmle Town Center 5, and expansion to follow in May. Elizabeth, thank you so much for coming in.
It's been a pleasure.
Good to see you.
Great to see you this morning.